Good morning, good morning, good morning. This is Anthony, NLP coach, core alignment coach, spiritual coach. I'm coming at you from the beautiful Beverly Hills. This is a beautiful walkway. If you ever get a chance to be in Beverly Hills, definitely walk on this path. It's such a beautiful path, and it leads to like the famous waterfall, which is down that way. And then there's another waterfall, which is this way, which is the one I'm going through today. So the subject I want to talk to you today about is stepping into the highest version of you, your highest self, your intuition, your heart. You can call it your heart space, or the highest divine version of yourself that you can be. And stepping into this place is actually rather easy, especially now that things are so accelerated. And coming from a spiritual aspect, it's like things are moving rapidly. More quicker than they've ever have. It's like things are coming to a climax. And this is beneficial, and it can feel really sucky too if you're not in it. If you're not in that flow, it can actually have an adverse effect. And this is where contrast or resistance comes from, speaking in Abraham Hicks terms. So there's a waterfall right across the street here. But stepping into your highest self is just a matter of feeling the feelings, being it, and then doing it. And it's all a matter of feeling, getting to that feeling place. There's a version of you that has done everything that you've wanted to do, including go after all of your desires, all the things that you want, all of the things that, you know, you've been inspired to go after. There's a version of you that has those things. The beautiful thing about this version of you that exists, you can call it parallel universes, call it whatever you want, call it, you know, tapping into this stream, this collective unconscious or superconscious stream of inspirations, artists, just spirits, whatever you want to call it. There's a stream that exists out there outside of us that is connected to anything and everything that's ever existed, including artists, musicians, politicians, whoever you want to think of, that exists out there in the ethers, if you will. And you can tap into it anytime. How do I know this is true? Well, because I'm a neuro-linguistic programming coach and I utilize a lot of the benefits of that stream in my practices and principles. But so let me give you for an instance here. I'm gonna give you a sample as a coach. So if I were to say, listen, who is your favorite musician or your favorite celebrity? I want you to think like that person. I want you to draw a circle on the floor, on the ground, right where I stand. And I want you to put that person in there. Put that person in there, put all of their feelings, their thoughts, the way they speak, the way they think, put that in there, put that in the circle. And then I want you to step into it. And I want you to really, really, really step into it. And I mean, exude it. Feel how that person would feel. Think how they would think. Say the things that they would say. Do that first thing in the morning. Really, really get into the process. Really assume it. Okay, so, you know, for instance, if I want to be like a Tony Robbins, I would put Tony Robbins in that box and I would think what he thinks, feel what he feels, and say what he says. And you will feel it automatically. Feelings are rising in you. A sense of confidence, a sense of ease, a sense of energy. You'll find yourself doing motions that you maybe never have done, or having, you know, just urges and tendencies that exude attributes of that artist or musician or celebrity. So this is one of the NLP techniques that's really, really old, and it's a very reliable technique, and it utilizes this stream, the ether, or whatever you want to call it.